hookup and up and down. And I start freaking out, y'all. Like, my test lit up, and like, I walked, you know, like, it's that. Sorry, I was selling a wig. Hey dolls, we're back. I am here today for a funny little story time. I know everybody's quarantining and chilling with everything that's going on, so I figure I will tell a funny story that y'all could laugh about. And yeah, this story is, as you guys can see by the title, how I found out that I was pregnant. This is the first time, so you guys know I have two babies, but with Aiden, I found out, like, I kind of knew already. But with Anthony, this was the craziest story, y'all. Like, I had no clue. Nobody around me had no clue. So, like, I'm going to just get into the story, okay? Before I start, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. And make sure you turn on those post notifications so you never miss the video that I drop. I'm going to try to get some good content out where everybody's at home chilling. So, be on the lookout. So, first, y'all, the date of the story is, we're talking 2017, the summertime, right? Okay. So, you guys know me and my boyfriend met each other around, like, well, we met in high school, but we started talking in, like, February of 2017, January, something like that. And then we started messing around then. So, this was, like, 6 months into us messing around, okay? So, it was randomly one day, my sister, Kirsten, she was in my birthday vlog. You guys know who that is. Anyways, my sister needed to take a pregnancy test because she was having a scare or whatever. You know, that's when she was a rookie. She thought she was pregnant. I knew she wasn't pregnant, but I'm like, okay, let's go. So we go to CVS together, y'all. And I bought the pregnancy test because I'm like, okay, girl, I don't need it, so I'll buy it for you. That was my first time ever buying one. I had never bought one before, nothing like that. So then I'm like, okay, I'll buy it. And then when we got up there, the security guard was like, you know, like, seeing what we was getting. He like, oh, okay. And then the lady up front, she was like, we was laughing and stuff. And the lady up front was like, everything goes okay for you guys. So I'm like, okay. She's like, let's take it right now. And I'm like, all right, let's go. So we go to the CVS bathroom, y'all. It had like a public bathroom, like two or three bathrooms. And we go in there. She's like, let's take it right now. I'm like, okay. So I 100% did not think nothing, like nothing. And it's funny because when we were driving there, I had said to her, I'm like, what if it's a plot twist and I'm pregnant and you're not? But I was just playing. Like, I honestly had no clue that. Nothing, like, I had nothing, y'all. I was just clueless. So, we was in the CVS bathroom, and we took them, and I looked down, and I started freaking out, y'all. Like, my test lit up, and, like, while I was peeing on it, like, it said positive. And I'm like, no, Kirsten. I'm like, Kirsten, no, like, something's wrong. Like, Kirsten, something is wrong. She's like, what are you talking about? I'm like, bro, look at this test. Like, I got a positive. So, she's like, well, maybe it's something wrong. Like, you should get another one, and like, we should just get another one. And I'm like, okay, yeah, I'm gonna buy another one because this has to be hormonal because I'm on birth control. Like, I'm on the shot. I have been on the shot for like 2 years. So, this is not a pregnancy, y'all. So, I'm like, I'm laughing at something my best friend just. So, I'm like, okay, something hormonal. Mind you, this is like on a Friday, I think.
Or Saturday.
It was on a Friday. And I think it was on a Friday. Yeah, I think it was on a Friday. So, okay, so this was on a Friday, right? So, I get the positive pregnancy test, and I'm like, no, this cannot be true. Mind y'all, it's funny, because I checked out the CVS thing on my mama's phone number, so she got the email receipt. So, we get back to my dad's house, and I'm like, bro, this is not true. Like, I'm not believing I'm pregnant at this point. I'm like, something's hormonal going on. Like, I'm going to go to the doctor and get a test, because that Monday, I had a doctor's appointment to get my birth control shot. Like, that Monday. So I'm like, okay, this must just be something wrong. I'm gonna just ask the doctor when I go to the doctor, whatever. So my mom texts me and was like, hey, is there something you want to tell me? And I'm like, what are you talking about? What? And she's like, and she sent me a screenshot of the pregnancy test. So I'm like, oh, that was for Kirsten. Like, she needed it and she didn't want her mama to see it, so I just used your phone number, you know, whatever. She's like, okay, cool. I hung up. I'm like, oh my gosh. So from jump, y'all, like, I'm gonna just be 100% honest. Like, from the jump, I was getting an abortion. Like, if I was pregnant, I never thought about keeping it. I didn't want to keep it. Like, I didn't want to keep it. So, me and Davon, literally 2 weeks before this, y'all, had broke up because I told him, like, I was busy. Like, if y'all remember from my first video, my Get to Know Me video, I was telling y'all, like, I was working an internship and had two other jobs and I was in school. Like, I was busy. This is summertime. Like, I was in school. And so I was super busy and I was just like, I don't really need distractions right now. Like, I don't really care for a boyfriend. Like, I just want to focus on me and just, like, you know, be in my bag. So we had broke up 2 weeks before that, right? And this is when all this is happening. So when I first found out, y'all, I texted him that night and I was like, so, you know, like, I got a positive test, like, but don't worry about it. I'm getting taken care of. Like, you ain't gotta worry about that. I don't want a baby. Like, don't think about it. Whatever. And he's like, okay, you know, like, if you need my support or if you need something, like, just hit me up. And I'm like, nah, I don't need nothing. We're good. Like, it's taken care of. Whatever. So the next day, that Saturday, I had to go to work. And so I had, like, bought, like, 3 pregnancy tests over the next day, y'all. Like, so I went to work and I had that in my bag or whatever. And it was in my trunk. So Alexis, my other friend, she pulled up, right? And she's like, I'm like, girl, I gotta tell you something. She's like, what are you talking about? And I'm like, I have to tell you something major, like, just something extreme. So she's like, okay. So I take her out to my car when I'm on break. And I pop open the trunk and she's like, confused. And I show her and it's like 4 or 5 pregnancy tests right there, sitting there. She's like, oh. And I'm like, girl, yes, like, I don't know what the heck, like, I don't know, like, but I'm gonna get it taken care of, like, don't even worry about it. So she's like, oh my God, you know, that's crazy, whatever. So the next day passes, then that Monday comes, y'all. So I go to the doctor that Monday, and the doctor's like, you know, hey, you know, everything doing good? Are you normal? Everything good? Any updates? I'm like, well, I did take a pregnancy test, well, a few of them over the weekend, and I got positives, but I was like, it must just be, like, something hormonal, right, because I'm on birth control. So she's like, okay, well, we can check and I'll just take a pregnancy test for you and, you know, we'll just see. So I'm like, okay, bet. Y'all, she goes take the test. She comes back and she's like, well, yeah, we can't give you a shot today because you're definitely pregnant. And I'm like, pregnant? Okay, whatever. So I'm mad, y'all. So I leave the doctor's. I think I went to go get my sister, Kirsten. Or she was already with me. No, I went to go get her. And then I was driving to Planned Parenthood because Planned Parenthood was down the street from my daddy's house. So I picked my sister up and I'm like, okay, we're going to go. So then I had texted my big sister, y'all. So I didn't tell her at first because she's pregnant with my nephew. She's like 8 months pregnant. So I'm like, okay, of course she's going to want to, like, tell me to keep it. And I don't need that right now. Like, I don't want to make her feel weird because I'm getting an abortion and she's pregnant. So, you know, I'm just like, not tell her. But then I ended up calling her anyways. And I was like, meet me at this address. And I didn't say Planned Parenthood. I just typed in the address. So she pulled up, y'all. And she's like, what? You know, like, what's going on? So I'm like, okay, long story short, I'm pregnant, but I'm not trying to keep it. Like, I just need you for support. Like, you're my sister. And I got Kirsten, my other sister. So I'm like, okay, we good. So we go in there, y'all, and I sign in, and then the lady came over there, she asked me for my insurance and all that stuff, and then she's like, you know, do you know how far along you are? And I'm like, no. I'm like, I'm pretty sure I'm early, but I don't know how far along I am because, you know, nobody gave me a, like, ultrasound. I was like, I just got the, you know, proof from my doctor or whatever. She's like, well, we're gonna need a sonogram to see how far along you are so we can know which procedure we gotta do and, you know, whatever the case is. And I'm like, okay, well, where can I get a sonogram from? She's like, well, you're gonna have to call an OB. And I'm like, I don't want to have to call OBGYN because I want to get this done, like, today. So she's like, well, we don't do same day procedures anyway. So I'm like, all right, whatever. So then I'm like, I tell my big sister, I'm like, how can I get a sonogram, like, today? Like, where can I get a sonogram from, you know, like, same day appointment? She's like, well, you can go to the hospital and pretend you're sick and get, like, go to the ER and just tell them you have a history of something and pretend your stomach hurt, whatever. So I'm like, all right, babe, like, are you gonna come? So her and my sister Kirsten came with me. Her and my sister Kirsten came with me to the ER, and I'm in there faking like my stomach hurt. The man took a pee test anyways, and I'm like sitting in the room and I'm pretending my stomach hurt. They're like, is there a chance you could be pregnant? And I'm like, no, it shouldn't be, like, no. So they're like, okay. So then he comes back, he's like, well, the pee test say you're pregnant. So he's like, we're gonna give you an ultrasound just to make sure you still have no stomach problems or no, nothing going on in your uterus since you're having pain. And, you know, we'll be able to, like, go from there. And I'm like, okay, whatever. So then they took me in there and they gave me the sonogram. So I'm asking the person, like, how far along am I? Like, is it a baby? Like, is it big? She's like, I can't tell you anything. I'm like, girl, just tell me something. She's like, I can't tell you anything. The doctor's gonna tell you. I'm like, okay, whatever. Then the doctor came back in and I'm telling my sisters, like, you know, I know the first time we did it because I was in college. So I was, like, seeing him every 2 weeks and every week. So it was easy to track, you know, like, how far along I could be. So I'm like, this is the furthest possible time I could be, whatever. So I'm like, but I'm probably, like, you know, 5-6 weeks. One of my jobs at the time, y'all, was Hooters. I was working at Hooters. So I was literally wearing the little tank top and booty shorts. Like, I was skinny.
You ended up talking about me?
No. Babe, come on, get what you need. Can you give me a rice pinch me and then you go? Y'all, the doctor come in and he's like, okay, so you're gonna have a baby before the year's over. I'm like, what? He's like, yeah, you're 14 and a half weeks. And I'm like, huh? He's like, yeah, 14 and a half weeks. You're, you know, almost four, like basically almost 4 months. Wait. Yeah, I was almost four. Wait. I don't know. I was like something. I don't know. He was some amount of weeks. I think it was like 14 or 15 weeks. And so I'm like, that changes everything. So I'm like, dang, like I'm way further along than I thought, y'all. Like I thought I was gonna be a couple weeks and it's gonna be just quick, easy, whatever. I'm looking it up online and stuff and I'm like, it's a whole baby, like it's a big baby. So I'm like, okay, all right. So he's like, yeah, you're gonna need to call an OB and get set up and, you know, get an ultrasound and get figured out, whatever. So I'm like, okay, great. So me and my sister left the hospital and I told my sister, like, okay, thank you for coming. So we all drove back to my mama's house. And I just put the papers down on my mama's, I just put the papers down on her thing and I'm like, here you go. This is what it is. She's like, confused. She was confused just like me. She's like, and I'm like, then I told her the day, she was like, what the heck? So then I took my sister back home and I took over my dad's house. And so I'm like, dad, I need to talk to you. Like, you come out on the porch, whatever. So I come out on the porch with him and I just give him the papers and I did the same thing and I'm like, and he's like, who is it by? Mind y'all, he had not met Davon yet. Like, I never introduced the boy to my dad yet. And we was only dating for a couple months. So like probably like 6 months. So I was like, I hadn't introduced him yet. So I'm like, well, we're kind of broke up right now, but you know, whatever. So after I found out how from Michael was, y'all, a whole couple days I'm like, no, I'm not telling Davon. Like, I'ma just be a single mother. Like, I'm telling my sister, like, I'ma just be a single mom and like I don't care, you know, whatever, whatever. So yeah, then me and Davon had some problems when I first found out, because you know, we had just broke up. And so I'm like, I have to go back and tell him, y'all, like, well, actually I am pregnant. He's like, what do you mean? I'm like, he's like, I thought you was getting taken care of. And I'm like, I was, but like now I can't. He's like, what do you mean you can't or you won't? And I'm like, nigga, like it's a whole baby. Like, I'm not about to do that. Like, no, we have to just accept it, whatever. So then fast forward, y'all, like 2 weeks passed by and I had the OB appointment. And this was like a couple days or like the day before, or like the day after 4th of July, something like that, right after then. So we had the first OB appointment and everybody came, y'all. Like, my dad was there, my stepmom, my little brother, my little sister, my mama, Davon, and I think it was a lot of people there. So y'all came to OB and literally they let everybody back there. So it's like 10 of us in the room. And so they found the gender out, whatever. And then after we found out the gender, then they gave the envelope to my sister because we was doing the gender reveal. So we did the gender reveal 2 days later, y'all, and Davon still hadn't told none of his family at this point. Like, none of his family at this point. So I'm like, they're gonna find out the gender reveal. Like, if you don't tell them, like, they're gonna find out. Like, it's social media, you know what I'm saying? Like, we live in Kansas City, so somebody's gonna see it and somebody's gonna tell. So he's like, you know, whatever. He invites one friend, y'all. Like, he told one of his friends. I think he told two of his friends, but he only invited one of his friends. Anyways, we had the little gender reveal and boom, you know, that was great, whatever. So then I think like the next day or like 2 days later, that's when Davon's family found out, because his ex-girlfriend called his little sister and told her. And so his family found out like that instead of finding out by Davon, because he was scared to tell them, y'all. And then, yeah, when I met them, they thought I was not pregnant because I was hecka small. Like, I was very small and I didn't look pregnant, but I was like 5-6 months. And yeah. And then when I went to my first OB appointment, y'all, the man told me when I went to my first OB appointment that I was further along. Like, when I got my first sonogram, she was like, how far along did they say you were? And I was like, well, I would be like 16 and a half weeks right now. She was like, no, you're 19 and a half weeks. So I literally jumped, like, I jumped right back up. And she was like, yeah, your due date is going to change from the 23rd of December to December 11th. And I'm like, so Yeah, it was just a mess, y'all. Like, so basically when I found out I was pregnant, I was like 4.5 months. And when I got my first sonogram, I was already 5 months. I was already like 19 and a half weeks. My gender reveal went by fast. Nobody believed me when I first told them, like, I was having a gender reveal. Everybody was like, a gender reveal for what? And I'm like, just come, y'all. Like, everybody thought I was hiding it. I'm like, no, I'm not hiding it. I literally just found out. The day I found out, y'all, the day I found out, me and my sister linked up with one of our friends and we smoked and I got high because I just cannot believe it. Like, honestly, I just couldn't believe it. And I'm about to show y'all a picture from the day, like the weekend before I found out I was pregnant. Like, people thought I was hiding it. I'm gonna show y'all a picture from, this was when I went swimming. This is June 12th. I found out I was pregnant like the next week. This was on June 12th. Me and my sister went swimming. Pregnant where? I was like 4.5 months pregnant at this point, y'all. Like 4 months pregnant. People thought I knew. Girl, I did not know. I just wanted to leave y'all a quick little fun story time. I know I talk fast, so don't say nothing about that. Yeah, but thank you guys for tuning in. I love you guys so much. I'm about to cook some dinner, y'all. I'm about to cook some fish and spaghetti. So that's what I'm about to do now. Tune into the next video. Good night, dolls. Mwah.
I came back to show y'all my dinner. Yes, it's on the paper plate because I ain't got time to wash dishes, y'all. It's finishing up. Got the Louisiana. Last piece of fish frying. Got the spaghetti. Something quick. I wanted to make some vegetables, but I ran out, so I have to go back to the grocery store. But I just want to show y'all my food. It's fire. Okay, bye.